Washington, Seoul, U.S. President Donald Trump is threatening to hold up a much-touted trade deal with South Korea to keep Seoul from leaning too far towards Pyongyang, a transactional approach to diplomacy that he may try replicating with Japan. "I may hold it up till after a deal is made with North Korea," Trump said of the revised trade pact in a speech Thursday. "Do you know why?" he asked. "Because it's a very strong card. And I want to make sure everyone is treated fairly." The White House said this week that the U.S. South Korea had finished renegotiating a bilateral free trade agreement that initially took effect in 2012. South Korea agreed to double its cap on American autos built under U.S. safety standards that can be sold there, as well as to accept an American tariff on South Korean pickup trucks through 2041 instead of the original expiration date of 2021. The pact also comes with a side deal that aims to keep Seoul from actively devaluing the yuan. In exchange for these major concessions, the U.S. agreed to exempt South Korea from a new 25% tariff on steel and aluminum imports. The South supplies under 10% of all American steel imports. The president, taking into account all relevant considerations, including negotiations with North Korea, will determine the best time to sign a finalized agreement on behalf of the United States, White House spokesperson Rod Shaw said in a statement. On a trip to Beijing earlier this week, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un told Chinese President Xi Jinping that he was committed to denuclearizing the Korean Peninsula. But he also stressed that South Korea and the U.S. must take progressive and synchronous measures toward peace. With Kim officially scheduled to meet with South Korean President Moon Jae-in on April 27, Washington worries that the North will persuade the South to ease sanctions and provide economic assistance without taking any concrete steps on denuclearization in return. South Korea considers itself a bridge between the U.S. and the North. It had hoped to broker an agreement where Pyongyang would fully commit to abandoning its nuclear program in exchange for the U.S. guaranteeing the Kim government's survival. But some in Seoul have begun advocating for a more gradual process following the Kim-Xi meeting. "The realistic approach is to reach a comprehensive agreement on denuclearization, then implement it step by step," an official close to Moon told reporters Friday. Seoul cannot openly reject Pyongyang's demands so soon after setting the date of their summit if it wants to maintain the detente with the North. Nor can South Korea ignore a China that seems to be doubling down on its support for the North. Meeting Friday with Moon, senior Chinese diplomat Yang Jiechi commended Kim for proposing gradual denuclearization, according to the South Korean government. Source said Moon and Yang held a detailed discussion on Pyongyang but revealed no further details. Meanwhile, the U.S. remains committed to its maximum pressure approach to make North Korea abandon its nuclear arsenal in a complete, verifiable and irreversible manner. Trump believes that past attempts at negotiation failed, as the North scored economic assistance while ultimately doing nothing in return. This time around, both Washington and Tokyo want Pyongyang to decommission nuclear facilities, move nuclear materials abroad, and submit to tough inspections by the International Atomic Energy Agency. Washington is concerned that fully denuclearizing North Korea will be difficult if Moon warms up to it too much. Senior White House officials have said Seoul is the weak link in the partnership between the U.S., Japan and South Korea. But Trump's aggressive rhetoric and his attempts to link economic and diplomatic issues could themselves damage the trilateral framework. The U.S. even hinted March 14, during talks on the revised trade pact, at a possible withdrawal of military assets from the South. The U.S. is also getting tougher on Japan, which it included in the steel and aluminum tariffs over Tokyo's strong objections. Trump appears to be going all out to advance his America First agenda ahead of the midterm congressional elections in November. Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe plans to meet with Trump around April 18, where he is expected to urge continued cooperation on North Korea. But Trump could demand major concessions on trade policy in return, as he did with South Korea, said an official at Japan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs.